I'm gonna say what people don't wanna say, all right? Stop giving chances to people that wouldn't give you the chance if they were in your position. Let me say that again. Stop giving people the chances that they wouldn't give you if they were in your position. If the world were reversed and you were the bum, okay, you were the one with no education, no job or a subpar job, no dreams, no aspirations, no car, no apartment, whatever the case may be, and they were the ones with the career, the degrees, the cars, the clothes, all of that, would they give you the same opportunity you've given them? If you say I don't know or no, why aren't you giving them that chance? Like, nah, bro, we need to rise up and stop giving these people chances. And this is my channel, and today we are going to be having another rant slash discussion about us, okay, us black women out there. And this has been something I've been wanting to talk about for quite some time now, but I didn't get around to it until just now. This video is probably called Why Black Women Date Trash. I could have easily called it Why Black Women Settle, but Why Black Women Date Trash is a lot better to me. Before we get into this video, make sure you smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, smash every button you know that can help a sister out on the road to 100K, posting Monday through Friday until we get there. Make sure you get my merchandise. This is my Black is a New Standard of Beauty sweatshirt. I got in a t-shirt and a hoodie. I got other designs as well. And check out the store if you haven't yet. And if you don't buy anything, it's okay. Just share the link. Pretty please. This video is sponsored by Car Marshal. If you need a new car, a used car, any car, Car Marshal is here to help you get that car, and not only help you get that car, but negotiate for you to get that car. Make sure you click in the link in the description box and in the pinned comment down below to get your new car today. There are a lot of people out there that constantly ask me, like, yo, why are you single? Why are you not in a relationship? You deserve to have someone who loves you. Blah, 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 blah. And I'm just like, listen, I'm not settling for no bum. I'm not settling for no subpar. I'm not settling for no nigga that can't match me or treat me the way that I need to be treated. And that's that. Like, it's very, very simple. While y'all out here trying to put up pictures on Instagram looking happy, when in actuality, yo nigga in my DM, yeah, I'm not trying to have no niggas do me like that. While you out here in the club with your man thinking he faithful, but when he leave you, he gonna be in my bed after he drop you off home. I don't need that type of negativity. While you're out here in school and at work and pulling doubles and shit, and your man is talking to me, I don't need that type of negativity in my life. Bottom line, a lot of these people ain't shit, okay? A lot of these niggas ain't shit, bitches ain't shit too. But I'm talking to my black ladies, okay, today. I'm talking to my black woman. But this shit needs to stop. And then you guys perpetuating this behavior of, oh, you need to date down, oh, you need to just settle, you need to just pick somebody, oh, you too picky. Don't let nobody tell you you're picky. Know yourself, know your worth, don't settle for shit. Don't let nobody tell you you need to settle. You don't need to do shit. You don't need to do nothing. You do not need to do nothing you're not comfortable with doing. If this man is not for you, he's not for you. For those of you who are on the same mindset I'm on, okay, especially as a black woman, I ain't got time to be settling down for no trash. I see way too many beautiful, educated, about their business black women settling for legit bums. Crying over legit bums. Bitching over men who can't do shit for them. No. I refuse to be that bitch, okay? I refuse to be that bitch out here bitching and crying over some nigga on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat that can't even pay his phone bill, okay? I refuse to be crying, bitching, complaining about some nigga on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat over some dude who can't even pay his child support. I refuse to be bitching, crying, complaining about some nigga on Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat over some dude who didn't even finish college. You feel me? I have a bachelor's. I get my master's in like a month or two. It was just like, I'm not about to sit here bitching, crying, complaining over no dude who don't match me, okay? I see way too many girls out there settling, okay? And comment down below if you agree, okay? I'm not trying to say be shallow. I'm not trying to say, oh,
don't date that plumber, he a plumber, what he gonna do for you?
I'm not trying to say that, but I'm saying, if you out here, you got 2-3 degrees, you got a stable ass 40-hour week job making over 60-70k, and you know, you bad as hell, you beautiful as hell, your savings got more than 10k in it, you got your own car, you got your own spot, and a dude out here working at as a plumber, he ain't got his own spot, he ain't got his own car, he ain't got nothing. What is he really offering you? Now, it's not even about offering someone something of monetary value, because realistically, you got your own money. You don't need no nigga, right? Personally, I would much rather somebody who match me, okay? And a lot of times, and I know there's gonna be a lot of people who are gonna comment down below like,
oh, but what if he's a good guy?
I do people think that just because someone's a good person or just because they're a good guy that they deserve everything in the world. Nice guys finish last. Let me stop, that's fucked up. But no, seriously. Just because you're a nice guy doesn't mean you deserve every woman you encounter. Just because you're a nice guy doesn't mean that you're the right guy for that said person. Just because you're a nice guy don't mean you deserve a girl that's way out of your league, okay? That may sound so fucked up, but it's the fucking truth. I'm gonna say what people don't wanna say, alright? I'ma say what a lot of females be thinking, but that's most likely why your DM ain't being answered, my guy. This is most likely why a lot of females ain't answering you. You need to level up. You need to get up there, okay? I'm not saying you have to have multiple degrees. I'm not saying you have to have a job that pays this X amount. But my thing is, you have to have that charisma. You have to have that drive, that motivation to do better if you're not where you want to be. You can't be out here just doing subpar shit and you want a woman that's all the way up here. It's just, it most likely ain't gonna work. I'll tell you this right now, okay? There's been times where I've lowered my standards, okay? Where it's like, I know what I want, I know what I need, and I still sit there and I get approached by these men that are nowhere near what I wanted, nowhere near what I needed, and I just was like, you know what? But he's such a nice guy. I give him a chance. He fucks me over beyond belief. Now I'm looking dumb and I'm crying over some nigga who can't even get me a fucking hot dog. Cause do not lower your standards, all right? Never lower your standards. What you want is what you want. And once you become what you want, you will attract what it is that you want. You will get what it is that you need. Stop giving chances to people that wouldn't give you the chance if they were in your position. Let me say that again. Stop giving people the chances that they wouldn't give you if they were in your position. If the world were reversed and you were the bum, okay, you were the one with no education, no job or a subpar job, no dreams, no aspirations, no car, no apartment, whatever the case may be, and they were the ones with the career, the degrees, the cars, the clothes, all of that, would they give you the same opportunity you've given them? If you say I don't know or no, why the fuck you giving them that chance? Like, nah, bro, we need to rise up and stop giving these people chances. I see there's too many black women in particular are like pick me women, okay? And if you don't know what a pick me woman is, if you see my recent video about this whole light skin versus dark skin interview, and the girl kept saying like, oh my god, like what about me, what about me, those type of bitches, the oh my god, like pay attention to me, oh my god, like pick me, I'm cute, I'm like the ooh me bitches, okay? Like, y'all know what I'm talking about. Those bitches, don't be a pick me. You look pathetic, you look sad, and you look dumb, okay? Don't be a pick me bitch, okay? It's disgusting, it's unattractive, and it just lowers your stock, okay? We need to learn how to heighten our stock, make our stock higher. Stop being a pick me bitch. It's not cute. I see a lot of women date down or date men that aren't on the same level as them because they want to feel like they're in control. So like, they'll date like super young guys that don't have it all together yet, or they'll date guys that aren't doing much with their lives because they want to have control in the relationship. They want to feel like, okay, well, I'm the breadwinner, so I make the rules, I do this, I do that. How many of you know people like that? Comment down below. I know plenty of them. You're really willing to be with a bum just so you could control him. Like, I think that's really crazy, and people like that need fucking therapy. Honestly, I may sound like an asshole, but like, I really don't fuck with men with kids. The whole men with kids thing is ridiculous. Like, lately I have been thinking, because it's like, I am getting older, and most people my age or older do have kids, and I'm just like, yo, like, deadass, I might just end up being a stepmother. But at the same time, I refuse to deal with anyone's baby mama drama. If I had my own kid, of course I would date somebody with a kid, because now we can relate. You know, we'd be a cute little Brady Bunch Wait, the Brady Bunch was not a blended family. You know what I mean? We could be a nice blended little family. We could be cute or whatever, you know? But I don't want to deal with nobody's baby mothers. I don't want to deal with any kids talk about stuff.
You're not my mom!
Because, like, I swear to God, like, I'll slap that kid into next week. Like, I don't have time for that. Like, I don't want to deal with no disrespectful ass kids. I don't want to deal with no disrespectful ass baby mothers. I don't want to have to fill in the slot of being somebody's fucking step parent. And then now when I have a kid with that person, now my kid can't relate to the other kids because we don't have the same parent. I just don't like that. I have a half sister. I don't like the whole half sibling situation. I genuinely don't. I want my kid to be your first kid, okay? I want us to build our family together. And that's just my personal preference. That's not yours, that's you, but that's mine. There's way too many black women out there settling and they are being abused, okay? Now, I don't mean they being beat the fuck up, even though there's a lot of them getting beat the fuck up. Please, please get some help. Like, I'm telling you, if you are in a relationship right now and you're getting beat up, you're being mistreated, please leave. There's hotlines, there's help, there's refuge places for you. Just please leave. Because you can die, your kids could die. It could end up being a very nasty situation. Please get help. But I see too many black women getting emotionally abused, you know? You got men out here saying that you're ugly and you're fat and you're disgusting and you ain't never gonna find nobody to love them. Meanwhile, this same dude is built like a motherfucking refrigerator, but he body shaming you. What's up with these dudes? I'll be damned if a nigga that don't got an 8-pack, 6'3", with beautiful hair, curly white teeth, gonna tell me badly shaped bitch and ain't nobody gonna want me, or I'm a whore and ain't nobody gonna want me, whatever the case may be. Like, I see way too much of that. Like, I see way too many ugly dudes, okay? Dudes who ain't about shit, dudes who don't look like shit, trying to downplay us black women. And it's like, listen, you ain't no Chris Brown, right? You ain't no motherfucking Trey Songz. So it's like, who do you think you are? Like, no. Stop letting these men that look like a sack of potatoes disrespect you, cuz. I am so sick of seeing beautiful, educated women with drug dealers, thieves, scammers, crackheads. What is wrong with y'all? Like, do you not know how poppy you are? Like, girls be out here with, like, legit degrees, harboring a whole goddamn fugitive in their apartment. What the fuck is you doing? Why do we think that this is acceptable? Why do y'all think this is okay? Why? Comment down below, like, why do some women think like this? If you were ever in this situation, why did you think like this? Like, listen, I used to be attracted to little bad boys, little thugs or whatever in high school, you know, like when I was 15. I'm 24 now. I'm not going for that shit no more. Like, no, you need to have a stable life, okay? Like, and the thing is, even if somehow you do get out of that lifestyle, okay? Say if you were a thug and now you stop selling drugs and you change your life. That shit follows you. Records follow you. That drug charge you got back in 1995 will follow your ass to 2008. Like, that shit follows you. Like, nah, I don't want no parts. I don't want no parts, okay? I don't want no parts. Like, I have enough hood niggas in my life. I know enough hood niggas, okay? If I wanted a hood nigga, I'd date one of them. I don't need no new ones. I'll stick to the crap I know. Woo! Too many of y'all settling for money, bruh. Too many of y'all settling for money. And I know right now that's the new thing, you know? We out here, we taking niggas for their money. What was the City Girls bullshit promoting? Putting drugs in men's drinks and taking their cards and taking their money while they're knocked the fuck out. I don't understand how y'all support this bullshit. Especially if you're a Haitian woman. Why are you still supporting the city bitches? Why are you still supporting the city girls when they're blatantly talking shit about Haitian women? Not only that, I just don't believe in promoting that type of shit, honestly. But then again, I mean, men talk about a lot of volatile shit too, so I mean, I guess that's just hip-hop. Maybe I should just cancel hip-hop, but that's for a whole nother fucking video. Why can't we get our own money? Why y'all gotta rely on niggas, scam niggas, take niggas' money? Why you think a nigga has to take care of you? I don't understand it. A nigga don't have to take care of you. A nigga don't have to give you shit. This is not 15 BC, okay? Y'all be out here expecting men to bring you a whole motherfucking cow, a mule, and a fucking shack. Like, no. Get your own shit. Get your money up. Go to school. Start a business. Do something. Like, why y'all keep relying on niggas? Like, I see way too many females like, oh, but the money's good. I'm staying with him because of the money. Da 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 da. Like, why don't you have your own money? Why? Like, you think that's cute? I don't understand. Especially to those of you with kids who are under any of these categories that I mentioned. Do you not understand that kids pick up on shit? My mom has been through a lot of shit with my father. My father's put my mom through a lot of shit. Granted, they're still together, and I do feel like that did help me to an extent, but luckily for me, none of that translated into my mind as, oh, it's okay for niggas to treat me like this. Or maybe it has subconsciously, and that's a lot of the reason why I do encounter fuck niggas. I don't know. But realistically speaking, kids pick up on everything. What message are you sending to your kids when you are accepting bullshit? Your kids see the bullshit. What message are you sending to those kids? What message are you perpetuating to people around you who look up to you? Stop accepting bullshit. It's not okay. The reason I see a lot of black women dating down or just dating trash is because I feel like a lot of us, and I've said this before in a couple of videos, black people are just not raised to be compatible. And by compatible, I mean like a lot of black people, whether you're foreign, African American, whatever the case may be, I see that they hold their men and women to different standards. Boys and girls are not raised the same. You have girls being raised to be independent, cook, clean, go to school. And then the boys are just, they get to do what they want. They get to go out. They get to stay out late. Some of them are pushed to go to school. A lot of them aren't. And if they are pushed to go to school, they're more likely to just be pushed. If they're not pushed to go to school, they're more likely to be pushed to get a job, you know, or, you know, find a woman that can do this, that, that for you. But they're not teaching their sons, oh, be able to do this for yourself, be able to cook clean. You know, that falls more on your sisters, the girls, the females. That doesn't fall on you. Shout outs to you men that were taught to cook, clean, do laundry and stuff like that. But I can say a lot of men watching this and a lot of men that you know in your mind right now watching this, ladies, don't know how to cook, clean, do laundry, or do anything else for themselves, and they rely on their girlfriends, their mothers, their aunts, their grandmothers, and all other types of shit to do it for them. And I think that's a problem. That's why we clash a lot. That's why when it comes to dating, it's like you got this independent black woman who knows how to do everything for herself, who has an education, who goes to find this black man who can't do nothing for himself. And sometimes he has an education, sometimes he doesn't. Sometimes he works, sometimes he doesn't. And for the most part, he can't do a lot of shit by himself, and he's expecting the girl to do it for him. But the girl's looking at him like, bitch, I got hella degrees and a job. Where do I got time to do this shit for you? Where? So it's just, it becomes like a clash, like a very bad clash. So then now you got black women degrading black men, and you got black men degrading black women. You know, you got the black man talking about something, oh,
you women can't do nothing these days, y'all want to support the black man, y'all want to support the black family.
You know, you got the black woman talking about something,
y'all motherfuckers want mothers and y'all can't fucking do shit for yourselves. I got this many degrees and I ain't doing shit for you.
And it just becomes a real sloppy ass motherfucking mess. Very interesting to see a lot of women go through this, and it's very interesting to see a lot of men go through this, because it's like a lot of black women is not having it these days. We are not doing shit for you. Okay, I mean, okay, I shouldn't say we, because I'll do shit for my man. Like, if you my man, I'll do a lot of shit for you. Like, I could still cook, go run my business and go to work and go to school. I could do that. Like, there's no problem with that for me. But it is a lot for a lot of women, and a lot of women feel like they shouldn't have to do that for a nigga. A nigga should be able to cook for himself. He should be able to clean for himself. He should be able to do his own laundry. He should be able to do everything for himself, because, bitch, I'm not your mate. And it's okay to have that fucking mindset. You just gotta find somebody to match your mindset. And I feel like a lot of people, especially black women, do not find their equal. They do not find someone that matches them. They date below because they don't want to be alone. They date below because they don't want to be stigmatized as, oh my god, it's because you're a black woman, that's why you're so lonely. You know, bitch, I don't care. I'll take that any day. I'd rather be single and happy than taken and miserable. Ain't nobody about to have me out here looking dumb as fuck in these streets, okay? So if you are one of those people, don't worry, you will find yours, okay? You will find your equal, you will find better. You will find someone who is going to treat you like the queen that you are. Don't let anyone try to talk you into settling just because. If you ain't find the one, then you ain't find the one, okay? You are the shit, and you shall be treated as such. And this goes for men and women, okay? If you haven't found your woman equal, if you haven't found your man equal, you will find him. You have to be what it is that you want to attract. If you ain't got shit and you want a bitch that has shit, she ain't coming to you, okay? She ain't coming to you. If you a bitch that ain't got shit, you want a nigga that got shit, most likely he ain't coming to you. Or maybe he will, but he's just gonna use your ass and you ain't gonna get nothing out of it, alright? Let me know what you think about this down in the comment section below. With that being said, make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that. Follow me on social media, and I'ma see y'all next time. Kato Productions.